My friends, today we honor the legacy and the gift of our loved ones who have passed away in the last year. And I hope you know that whether or not they were part of this church community, we are all in this moment lifting one another up so that we can all experience the peace and love and light of Christ. So friends, let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, for all the saints who have ever worshiped you in this church or in their homes, among your flowers and trees, and across the world. We give you thanks, O God, for hands lifted in praise, manicured hands and hands stained with grease or soil, strong hands, aged hands, holy hands. We give you thanks, O God, for hard-working saints who knew the value of a hard day's work and the value of a good night's rest. We give you thanks, O God, for the tremendous sacrifices made by those who have gone before us, ways that we have been shaped and formed by them to be your people of love. Bless all these, and may we learn how to walk in their faith, dedication, worship, and love. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Friends, we will now name and light 5 candles for those loved ones who were members of Bracken. The 6th one, I will hold silence for all of us to lift up those that we loved as well. Susan Coffey. Becky Bird. Kathy Wiest. Bernice Knight. Myrtle Stotts. My friends, receive this blessing. It's from a poem called The Blessing of Hope by Jan Richardson. So may we know the hope that is not just for someday, but for this day, here, now, in this moment that opens to us. Hope not made of wishes, but of substance. Hope made of sinew and muscle and bone. Hope that has breath and a beating heart. Hope that will not keep quiet and be polite. Hope that knows how to holler when it is called for. Hope that knows how to sing when there seems little cause. Hope that raises us from the dead. Not someday, but this day. Every day, again and again and again.